Hey guys, quick shop update. It is a beautiful day here, 75 degrees in early March, which is awesome. They are doing the painting in here, which is looking great. Running electric right now, which actually is one of the last things to do. We're gonna move in, I think, in a few weeks into this room right here, at least. Here it is, the new compressor. Atlas Copco GX5FF, 7.5 horsepower rotary screw. Super excited, folks. I learned a ton and spent a fair amount of time researching this. We're gonna do a separate video on the process of buying it, what to learn, the hazards, the risks, what we like, what we don't like. I'm excited to get this thing plugged in. It should be super quiet. So more to come on that, but it's gonna live about right here. At least that's the plan, and I am excited. I had two questions for you guys though that I wanted help or advice on. One of them actually relates back to the air compressor, which is all of our lines came in. This is the fast pipe stuff from Rapid Air. Great reviews, super excited for it. Actually, pain in the butt to go through and make all these decisions and map out the shop and try to get everything in the first order. And we're gonna run the fast pipe around the perimeter of each room, each bay here. And basically, at every length, we'll have, every intersection of pipe will have a drop, perhaps more when needed. My question is really, at what location on the wall should I run the pipe? I assume there's no real drawback to running it pretty high up, perhaps right below the steel there in that example. And I guess on this wall, we'll have to go around some of the electrical and so forth. But is there anything I'm not thinking of or any reason we should run it at a different height? I guess I don't really want to run it around chest level, although maybe that would save me some drops. That wasn't how I had penciled it out in the sketch, but would appreciate any advice on that. The second question is, we need a better way to store raw material and inventory of stuff here. We've got this rack now in our current shop. We like it, we'll keep it, but it also really wastes a lot of volume, and it makes it difficult if you've got lots of pieces stacked up on top of each other. So one of the things I'm thinking I'd like to do is some sort of a tubing type system where you've got individual tubes that you can put, you know, one or a few pieces of round bar or square bar, maybe a little bit of lighter weight stuff, you know, not a big 4x4 inch piece. But I was wondering, maybe even just doing Home Depot PVC and having PVC that runs along to support it, and perhaps you build end caps and even a center support that holds the tubes in place, or maybe you plasma cut something with circles that looks nice. But you know, I always kind of think like when you see the videos of the nuclear fuel rods going in with that honeycomb shape. I mean, that to me would make sense. But what do you guys recommend, or what's a smart way to store lots of different material? And last, I'll walk you guys through the office portion. The insulation has gone up, which has really changed the feel, which is really cool, because now you start to see each room sort of defined. The noise has been cut down a lot, which is actually really nice. It doesn't have that industrial echo. It feels more like a place where you can work, and that's really exciting. The sheetrock just got delivered yesterday. It was actually a pretty cool truck. I've seen them, but I've never seen one really used up close. So that was cool. Actually, they're starting that right now. So that's, I guess that's on tap today. Internet's getting installed, and yeah, I think once we get the compressor set up and some of the power, we're gonna move. I think the plan is around the 22nd of March, at least into this bay. The office won't be done. That's the goal, folks. Appreciate it. Let me know what you think on where to run these and about material storage. And thanks to my buddy Chuck, who hooked us up with a lift. This is gonna make it super easy, or easier to run those air lines.